K98 Talk is expanding its lineup for 2015. This means we are expanding our advertising base. Whether you're a startup trying to push through to the next level, or an established business trying to supplement your advertising budget, web-based advertising is a solid investment. Thanks to Talk's newest partnership with TuneIn Radio and instant access to our sister station, K98 FM, we give you worldwide access at a reasonable cost. Interested parties should email us at sales@k98fm.com.
In these uncertain economic times, you've got to do whatever you can to save money. One of our biggest expenses can be our cars, especially when unexpected repair bills hit. Not anymore. If you own a vehicle with less than 130,000 miles, is less than 12 years old, has a warranty about to expire, or even no warranty at all, you could stop paying for car repairs. Roadside assistance, towing, and rental coverage are all included. Don't wait for the next repair. Make one free call right now to see if you qualify. If your vehicle is less than 12 years old, has less than 130,000 miles, even if it's out of warranty, paying for car repairs can become a thing of the past. Call us right now and get your car protected before your next repair bill hits. Get protection and no more repair bills. Call 800-696-1030. Again, 800-696-1030. That's 800-696-1030. 800-696-1030.
Joe had huge problems with the IRS.
I knew it was coming. I hadn't filed taxes since 1990.
All the IRS letters coming in added up to a nightmare.
To get up to like $68,000, my heart started beating fast. It's like, there's no way, man. I mean, I ain't going to be able to do this.
Then they stopped his paycheck.
So that's when I started making phone calls and found U.S. Tax Shield.
U.S. Tax Shield went to work immediately.
They just took the bull by the horns. What blew my mind is he called the IRS right then and there.
So why is U.S. Tax Shield A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau? Joe knows.
They saved me a ridiculous amount of money.
If you owe more than $10,000 to the IRS or state, choose the company Joe chose, U.S. Tax Shield.
It was the best decision I made. U.S. Tax Shield is the way to go. Life is good. Thank you, Lord.
Call 800-471-3287.
U.S. Tax Shield. Boo-rah. Yes.
800-471-3287. 800-471-3287.
Game on, where progressives fear us and rhinos tremble. Welcome to the political jungle. I'm JD.
This is Stacey. No one is safe. No one is spared.
Lock up the children.
And the old folk.
Welcome to the world of libservative conservatarian.
It's not Sunday, baby. It's Ron Day. I look over in the chat room, and who do I see? I see King Ron. Good, easy Sunday morning, April 17th, 2016, 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. JD and Stacey, game on, part of that Conservative Commandos radio network here on K98 Talk. Welcome back to all our political geeks, freaks, and back alley sneaks. Everybody within the sound of my very, very Sunday morning voice, you know exactly what to do. You get over to K98Talk.org, get in that chat room, say hello to Stacey, say hello to the smartest, drunkest, drug taking, his nakedest Ron, sending the pictures. Oy vey, schmear radio listening audience in the business. JD and Stacey, baby, your offshore radio bank account. Good morning, baby.
Good morning.
How are you?
Running very low on caffeination.
Now let Martha and the Vandellas wake you up. For those of you who are new to the show and you don't know, baby, you got nowhere to run to, nowhere to hide. Game on, JD and Stacey, Sunday Morning Madness. This is the part, baby, where they go crazy and the chorus comes back. This morning we're going to be talking Bernie and DePopa, upcoming Supreme Court cases and where we stand. Weekend update by that Mr. Eric Williams of that barbedwiresatire.com, baby. Nonsense of the world and more. Remember, guys, we're not just here live for Game On, 11 a.m. Sunday mornings here on K98, curing your mainstream media hangover. Stacey and I are live again on K98 every Tuesday and Thursday night, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for another edition of Game On. Friday, 5 p.m. drive time. We got a little show, a little media market called Philadelphia. Oh, by the way, we are the drive time leading to Yahoo Sports. Yeah, it covers Southern Jersey and Northern Delaware as well. Big whoop. Want to fight about it? Oh, where do you find it? 5 p.m. Fridays Eastern Time. WNWM doing JC 1360 a.m. on that Conservative Commandos radio network. Any of our listeners in the Dallas metro area, Stacey and I are negotiating to get up in that Dallas market. We're going to make Dallas bigger than those Cowboys. Number four pick in that draft, baby. We've secured a couple of sponsors. Could always use a couple of more. Any of you who would like to see us up in the Dallas market continuing to take over the world, email Rick, R-I-C-K at K98talk.org. And remember, Hooples, after the show, not during it, get over to Spreaker.com, hashtag JD and Stacey, JDANDSTACEY. Find a catalog of everything we've been doing here with that Ricky Ticky Tavi Rick Robinson, the K98 talking, that Rick Trader over at 1360 WNJC. Good morning, baby.
Good morning.
Lou and Dr. Ray Sundays anymore or no?
I believe not. They have transferred specifically to Thursdays now.
Now, here's the question. So, yeah, stick around at 12 o'clock. If the guy comes on talking about Jesus, no Lou and Dr. Ray.
I think we have some new Sunday shows lining up, but I think Lou and Dr. Ray are just on Thursdays now.
And for those of you who don't know JD's feelings about Sunday morning shows.
I hate this place. Nothing works here. The medications don't work. I've been here for 7 years.
We've been on for 7 minutes. I feel like it's 7 years.
There you go.
How's your weekend?
You haven't slept in a year, so.
Oh, it's more than that. It's more than that. Now I have actually become the undead.
The undead? Fabulous.
You can't kill me. I got in an argument in the bar the other day. Guy shot me with a shotgun. I was like,
interesting.
You were like, hey, man, I'm sick of your nonsense. I got right up, I walked him, I looked him right in the eye, and I was like,
hey, where are the white women at?
And then I realized I was at a bar in Brooklyn, so I had to go to the city.
Okay, terrific.
I'm sorry, Italian-looking man, you're in the wrong borough.
I can't wait to launch this website because I think my complete accounting of the number of things that we actually have in common is almost accurate.
Which our website?
Yeah.
Oh, that's right, baby. You're going to be sticking around. That JDNStacey.com coming your way really, really soon. It's finally going to have a place to put all of our nonsense. And I got a place. We finally got a place where Stacey can't get away from me. Without further ado, Hoopers, the reason you get up on that Sunday morning, baby, turn into that K98talk.org to listen to JD and Stacey on Game On, is because right now we're going to bring to you that weekend update for the weekend in April 17th, 2016, brought to you by that Mr. Eric Williams of the barbedwiresatire.com, baby. Williams, I haven't even started, and you start me off with Springsteen and Bryan Adams. Bruce Springsteen and Bryan Adams both canceled upcoming concerts, so what, 9 people were affected? In states that have passed bathroom privacy laws recently, they feel those states are bigoted and discriminating against gays. Reportedly, the boss is considering changing the name of his band to Bruce Springsteen and the LGBT Street Band. Let me tell you something, okay? This bathroom nonsense has got nothing to do with being gay, because I guarantee you, if I was at a Jet game with no door on the stall, and I'm taking a dump Dumpasaurus Rex, I don't think people would be lining up to ask me out on a date. Go!
Despite big wins in Wisconsin and Colorado, Ted Cruz has had to listen to all of the pundits claim he still has no path to 1237 delegates. However, Cruz maintains that thanks to Common Core math, he can get there. There is just no easy way of explaining it that way, in a way that may...
Yeah, there was, that's right. There was no way in explaining that joke that made any sense. At a rally this week, I'm sorry, Eric. I know that was a dig at Jeb Bush. I'm just being a jerk off. At a rally this week, actor Tim Robbins and another. At a rally this week, actor Tim Robbins announced he is supporting Bernie's and called Clinton supporters, quote, sheep. Hillary is said to be demoralized about losing Robbins' support since she was hoping to rely on his expertise in tunneling out and crawling through long prison pipes. Your skank redemption. Hold on a second. In case I laughed you through the punchline, this is genius. Hillary is said to be demoralized about losing Tim Robbins' support since she was hoping to rely on his expertise in tunneling out and crawling through long prison pipes. Hash brown, Shawshank redemption.
Showing how seriously they take politics, two of the Trump children are ineligible to vote for their dad in the New York primary next week because they didn't register in time. In typical Trump fashion, Eric and Ivanka released a statement blaming others, saying the people they paid to go register for them apparently dropped the ball.
Trump and ball dropping. Politically correct Sesame Street on... Williams, if this isn't a great joke, this has got potential with Sesame Street. Politically correct Sesame Street unveiled the newest Muppet on the Afghani version of the show, a hijab-wearing girl named Zari. Next season, Zari will migrate her entire Muppet family to America, where they will gang rape Big Bird and Bert and Ernie will get tossed off the top of a tall building. Watch your back, Beaker.
Continuing her pandering to the black community, Hillary got the endorsement of Trayvon Martin's mother, where she told a black group that George Zimmerman should never have been allowed to have a gun in the first place. She then said, of course, if Trayvon hadn't been running on CP time, he could have gotten his Skittles and got his butt home before ever crossing paths with Zimmerman to begin with.
Let's go back to the joke before that. That combined...
Oh, durka, durka, durka.
With tossing Bert and Ernie off a Muslim rooftop
line...
Three
simple words. I am gay.
Williams just won Sunday. The Clintons have hit a rough patch with the black community. Hillary on CP time, and Bill had to apologize for an outburst when Black Lives Matter folks challenged him during a speech. Bill later halfway apologized, blaming his outburst on old age. He then conceded, of course it could also be AIDS, hepatitis C, herpes, syphilis, or Viagra talking.
The leaker of the Panama Papers was revealed this week. David Lee Roth has held the rights to the Panama Papers since he wrote the hit song Panama on pieces of paper in the 1980s. Asked why he released the documents at this time, Diamond Dave said, if I didn't do it, Sammy Hagar would have. Excuse me.
Hash Brown, Weekend Update, brought to you by that Mr. Eric Williams of that barbwiresatire.com.
I think Eric got you this week.
Hold on, I gotta hit the audio in my bubble. Hold on one second. Are you back?
I think I'm back. I was gonna say, I think Eric got you this week.
Oh, that was good. That was good. Let me go through the winners here. I was totally in after Big Bird got gang raped and Bert and Ernie got tossed off a tall building for being gay.
Okay, terrific.
I'm really not surprised by that at all.
Mm-hmm. Oh God! So, as if the 2016 presidential primary election on both sides of the aisle hasn't gotten strange enough, within the last few days, our very own
boom, boom, boom. I had a very good debate over at CNN with Hillary because I finally care about her damn emails, and now... yes, I grew up Jewish, and I am Jewish, but I am going to the
secular
land...
secular Jewish person.
I am going to the land of the Pope, and I hear they have organs.
So in the
comes down to something very simple. The Pope is a socialist.
He is. And actually what we're speaking about is we're speaking about a political move that I think is going to be spoken about for quite some time after this election and nominating process is locked up. And right now we're going to take a look at the Democratic side of the aisle instead of the Republicans for a while, because when we come back and look at the Republicans at some point, it'll still be a stone cold mess. So what you have is you have it's funny. I see a similarity on the Democratic side in the primary that I do with the Republican side on the primary. And that is, if you took this race and started this race now or within the last 2 weeks with just the candidates that are in it, Bernie and Uncle Speedo and the Empress of Chappaqua on one side, and Ladani, Trumpkins, hand off Schmeckle, ear on radio, hand off Schmeckle, ear on radio, Ladani and Ted Cruz. And you know what? I'm not even going to say it. He's going to be the man whose name we don't say. We're just going to do this every time we have to mention him. Because this guy is beginning to be a jerk off of monumental proportions.
I'm the mailman, as you can see.
So if you take a look at the polling, if this race had all started 2 weeks ago, and again, yes, I know, if grandma had balls, she'd be grandpa. So it's ifs and buts were candy and nuts. But if it did, you'd have a lot of states, I think, that went Trump originally. I don't think that you would have that same run up till now. And you've had Ted Cruz, through his ground game and the delegates, be able to close this gap and make this a race looking like he's going to prevent Trump from going into the nomination. Now, on the other side, you have Uncle Speedo, who actually forced Hillary Clinton into another debate this past Thursday, which was unscheduled, which she had no intention of doing because the Empress has already running a general election campaign. Speedo has the debate. He's had a bunch of good weeks. He is closing on her in New York. She had a 40 or 50 point lead at some point in New York. He's within 6 to 10 points of her. He has
had a huge rally, too.
He had a great 27,000 people the night before the debate. He has a phenomenal debate Thursday night. And then with the primary on Tuesday, jets off not to meet the Pope, but to finagle the Pope passing him as he goes to an airplane at 6 o'clock in the morning and shaking his hand.
Well, I mean, he was originally invited to speak at a conference regarding the economic and social global footprint that the Vatican has been having for several years. And because he's a, you know, communist, you know, the Vatican.
I'm a socialist, young lady.
The Vatican proposes a moral free market economy, i.e. socialism, dividing things up, making sure everybody gets their fair share.
Me being a communist is being floated by the Clinton campaign and the colored people who do not like me.
Well, you know, I mean, his ideals line up as far as economic justice very well with the current Pope, as we've heard the Pope speak about many times. I just find it so interesting that they have absolutely nothing in common on the social side of the House when you look at gay rights, abortion, and other things. Of course, if you're a Democrat, you call those women's rights. Abortion isn't a right, but we won't get into that. You know, there's a huge disparity between the progressive left and the Pope when it gets to things beyond a more just and equitable economy.
No, but I do think it's funny because, you know, when I first read this story, a lot jumped out at me and said, you know, if there was ever a time you wouldn't want to leave a state, especially one like New York, especially one where Bernie can pick up delegates, you know, a new national poll came out and showed that there's a 2-point race basically within the margin of error nationally between he and Hillary for the preference of the Democratic nominee.
Now, but he spanks everybody in a general head-to-head. It's actually kind of funny.
He does, but none of that is going to matter unless these superdelegates defect. Now, as he's making this a close race, he inexplicably leaves New York to go to the Vatican. Now, at first I thought this was insane because as you go through the stories, he had no formal meeting arranged with the Pope. As a matter of fact, the Pope was very reticent to even meet with Bernie Sanders because he has a statement how he doesn't want it to be seen political. However, I sat down and I thought about this, and I really, 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 really wanted to break Uncle Speedo's chops because in an article here in the Times, if Mr. Sanders were in the this was his meeting. He shows up to Rome and the Vatican for a conference. The Pope is not attending. He doesn't want to meet Uncle Speedo because he doesn't want to get pulled into the American election process. Uncle Speedo, if Uncle Speedo were in the foyer of the Casa Santa Marta Church at 6 a.m. the next day, he would be able to speak briefly with Pope Francis as the Pope headed to the airport for his Saturday trip to Greece, where the Pope would be addressing the migrant crisis. Now, we're just hitting the break mark. We're going to run over by a minute or two. What I actually sat down and thought about, at first I'm like, I'm going to stand here, and I'm a Jew, and the Pope's going to pay. Because basically the Pope sold this as, I walked past him as I was leaving to the airport, I shook his hand, we didn't talk about anything crazy, that's the polite thing to do. However, I honestly think it may have been extraordinarily smart politically, because the story, besides you and I getting into the minutia right here and saying the Pope really didn't have a formal meeting with Uncle Speedo when he passed him at 6 o'clock in the morning, it was like, crazy old Jew in America, a Pope, I love Jesus, and give him a bless. But the story back here in America is, because we live in sound bites, the story is Uncle Speedo went to meet with the Pope. And at first I was like, who cares? New York State, I think, has the second or third highest Catholic population in the country. And the Catholic population is all embedded in the Northeast and the Mid-Atlantic. Those are the states that are coming up. Those are the states that are pretty delegate rich. And I think that this,
Mr. Pope, please bless the Jew,
that makes sense to me from that point of view. We're at about a minute over. Why don't you take about 30 seconds, 60 seconds? You want to know what?
Yeah.
Let's do this. Why don't we come back after the break and wrap this up? Because I want to touch on a couple of things real quickly that the Pope and Bernie are aligned on, and then we'll go into SCOTUS. Does that work?
Works for me.
All right. And speaking about working, baby, we're going to pay a couple of bills. JD and Stacey here on that Sunday morning Game On, curing your mainstream media hangover. Game On, part of that Conservative Commandos Radio Network, here on that K98 Talk. It's Sunday morning, which means he's been up all night doing cocaine, and he's in my basement. Diamond Dave!
One break coming up.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it. There to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry, or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
If you like your health care plan, you'll be able to keep your health care plan. This is the most transparent administration in history. Not even a smidgen of corruption.
Fact is, we had 4 dead Americans. What difference at this point does it make?
If you've got a business, you didn't build that.
The feeling most people get when they hear a Barack Obama speech, Mike, I felt this thrill going up my leg. I don't have that too often.
Steady.
It's time to hear the truth about America's biggest challenges. Ricky Robinson, host of America Off the Rails, will tackle the important issues facing America today as he tries to keep America from coming off the track. Get ready to hear the truth every Monday through Friday starting at 7 p.m. Eastern, 6 Central, here on K98Talk.com and the Spark Radio Network.
Are you conservative in a world of liberal?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you're not alone. Hey, I'm Daniel Stafford, host of the Stafford Voice, and I'd like to invite you to tune in each Monday, 10 p.m. Eastern, where I'll break down the events of the week, and together we'll learn about how they affect you. So, sit back and get ready for the good, the bad, and the ugly of talk radio right here on K98 Talk.
From the Vikings of Norway to my home down south to Washington, D.C., I've been around. I've seen it all, and I've come out on top. You better beware, for all you know, the bell tolls for you. Enter the bell tower or watch your step. 8 p.m. Thursdays, K98 Talk.
Welcome back, JD and Stacey. Game on, your Sunday morning radio acid trip. Everybody right now within the sound of my voice, you know exactly what to do. Get over to K98talk.org, get in that chat room, say hello to Stacey, join the conversation, say hello to the drunkest, craziest, smartest, oy vey schmear, nakedest political listening audience in the business. I'm telling you guys, get over to K98talk.org. You don't want to miss a moment of what goes on in that chat room. Sometimes it's better than the show. Remember, guys, we're not just live here Sunday, 11 a.m., hearing your mainstream media hangover. Game on here on K98 Talk. We're live again Tuesday, Thursday nights, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard. Friday, 5 p.m., we're the drive time lead into Yahoo Sports on the WNJC 1360 AM, part of that Conservative Commandos radio network. After the show, Hoople's not during it, get over to Spreaker.com, hash brown, JD and Stacey, JDANDSTACEY. Find a catalog of everything we've been doing with Ricky Tiggy Tavi, Rick Robinson, K98 Talk, that 1360 WNJC, Conservative Commandos radio network. And remember, to all our Dallas fans, Stacey and I are negotiating to come up in the Dallas market. Secured herself a couple of sponsors, looking for a couple of more. Anybody within the listening area who knows anybody in Dallas who may want to sponsor or advertise, reach out to Rick, R-I-C-K, at K98talk.org. For those of you who went to public school, that's K98talk.org. Welcome back.
Good morning.
Mr. Pope, we agree on a lot of things and the income inequality, and I agree with you, but I live in a little house in the woods in Vermont, and you live in this giant palace here in the Vatican. The income inequality between you and the Popes is not as good as the equality of the roast beef sandwich.
No, but I mean, going back, I think your comments about it being politically smart are pretty much on target. I mean, when you look at the concentration of people who are Catholic, it's in those states that are upcoming where Bernie was having some issues in terms of closing in on Hillary Clinton. In addition to that, it also puts him on a quote-unquote global stage. I mean, in the absence of the presidential race and the presidential primary, I do not believe Bernie Sanders would ever have been invited to speak at the Vatican.
No, but you know what I find very, you know, the Democratic Party really is interesting. They take so many of their disparate coalition voting blocks for granted. So you have a lot of Northeast and Mid-Atlantic Catholics who have voted Democrat for the last 20 or 30 years. And basically, you know, white Catholics are one of the groups that these same candidates rail about their privilege. So please vote for us and shut up so that we can make fun of you. And I think that it was so smart on Bernie's side to try and co-opt it, because, you know, people don't speak about the Catholic vote in this context because it's happening on the Democratic side. And, it's like, we don't want to let people know we like the Catholics. But if you think about it, you know, the big deal in the 1960 election when Kennedy won the first time, the biggest talk going was the Catholic vote and what that meant. And I want you to go back to the last election cycle in 2012. The Catholic vote is very important, and it gets talked about on the right. It was one of the reasons that Rick Santorum had such a good run in the 2012 election cycle. Catholics really helped him in a lot of the Catholic-heavy states that he went into.
Now, I am not a Catholic. I am a Brooklyn Jew, but I did go meet the Pope.
I wanted to go through real quickly. There were a few issues that Bernie sounds exactly like Pope Francis about. This was from ABC News. And basically what they went over is that his language, even though he's a Jewish liberal candidate who supports abortion and gay marriage, which is completely anathema to even this Pope and the Catholic doctrine, when you talk about political engagement, wages, family, unemployment, war, climate change, health care, and income inequality, Bernie and the Pope are both singing from the same hymnal.
Well, the Pope is South American. When you look at South America, I mean, what does not have some socialist redistributive, you know, leanings? You know, Venezuela's done such a good job with it, you can't even get toilet paper there
anymore.
It's
not just the Pope, it's the whole Catholic shtick. Think about it. You're a guy, right? And you're like, oh, okay, what am I going to do with my life? I was a bartender, that didn't work. Then I was at a male escort, that was kind of dangerous. What am I going to do? Oh, I go to the seminary. From the day you go into the seminary, you are fed, you are clothed, you are kept in the lap of luxury, your travel is taken care of, and every once in a while you got to pop out a few Our Fathers and a few Hail Marys. So of course they're socialists, of course they're... Uncle Speedo basically wants to be a car. I just figured it out. Uncle Speedo.
Boom, boom, boom.
I would like to be the first Jewish cardinal in the Vatican.
Could you see him going through the cardinal test? First question.
Who is your daddy and what does he do?
His name is Saul and he worked in the deli.
Oh. I mean, yes, the Catholic Church does take care of many of its folks. Actually, the responsibility of that is generally left to the orders, not the diocese. And I never saw too many living in the lap of luxury outside the Vatican.
The Jesuits do. Trust me, the Jesuits do. Wrapping this up, not to be left out of any news cycle, Donald Trump mocks Bernie Sanders' meeting with Pope Francis. Quote, you know, he went to see the Pope.
5 minutes.
Then he came out. He said, we talked about the environment. We talked about global war. We talked about all these different things. And I said, wait a minute. He was only there 5 minutes. So the Pope gave him 5 minutes. This actually sounded like him being pissy about all this.
Well, what hasn't he been pissy about since he, I don't know, announced?
Oh, I love it. The kids can't vote for him. I think that is the...
No,
the,
that's awesome. The best what thing. I love even more is just him showing on a daily basis he has no idea how the primary election process works. And neither do his supporters. It's really...
No, I mean, when you keep hearing how he's not sending people here on the ground, Nebraska and Wyoming were two other places where I read he really had no surrogates on the ground.
They said none.
Each one of those caucus settings was like basically a cruise pep rally. All right. I've had enough of Uncle Speedo for the day. Let's,
I've had enough of Donald Trump for a year. Is that...
I guess this could be our Supreme Court music. Mm. All right. We have not spoken a lot about the Supreme Court since the death of Justice Antonin Scalia. But it looms larger and more important, I think, than it ever has. And for those of you who are unfamiliar with exactly what's going on up to date on the court, Supreme Court is made up of 9 different justices. Nominally on our Supreme Court, we have what people refer to as 5 conservative justices and 4 liberal justices making up those 9 justices.
Well, we did. We might not anymore.
On the 5-4 decisions. Just let me finish where I was going with this. With the death of Anton Scalia, that made the court 4-4, but it really doesn't make the court 4-4 because Republican presidents have been absolutely awful in nominating what they think are people with conservative judicial philosophies and are strict constructionists and really conform to original intent. They don't, because all the swing votes that... So basically, the Republican-appointed justices can always be counted on at the Supreme Court to become a winning swing vote for a liberal issue. But a liberal Supreme Court justice is very, very rare. If at ever, they'll become a swing vote to support a Republican issue. So now you have the death of the intellectual leader of the right on the court, Antonin Scalia. It now leaves the court divided 4-4.
What happens when the court's divided 4-4, J.D. and Stacey? What if there's a tie?
Good question, Bob. What happens in the event of a tie in a case being adjudicated at the Supreme Court coming out 4-4? Is basically it's remanded back down to the last federal appellate division, and the ruling from that division stands and applies.
Why should I care, J.D. and Stacey? I got to go to work tomorrow.
So do I, and I'm worried about who the Jets are going to draft for the 20th pick. However, this
why?
Is this why? Because
I'm
this
sorry.
Is what, this,
keep
you,
going.
You want to know what? You deserve this. And now that you've caused me to shift gears, I'll tell you why. Because it's going to matter whether it's Robert Candice, who's still available. I'm a big fan of seeing Paxton Lynch up there. They just traded for Ryan Clady, so do they want to find a younger offensive left tackle to develop behind him? Would you like to join the rest of this conversation?
No, okay. Not at all.
So
I think we're probably not going to broadcast between the pregame season and the Super Bowl.
Oh, that's fine. I'll find somebody who'll do radio with me. So,
all right.
At the end of last year, when the calendar, I think the Supreme Court calendar and session starts in October or November. So prior to Justice Scalia's death, there were really 5 important Supreme Court cases to keep your eye on for 2016. They were Evan Weller v. Abbott, which is basically the one person, one vote case. The court's going to decide if eligible voting population numbers can be substituted for population numbers when voting districts are determined. Fisher v. the University of Texas at Austin, that's an affirmative action case. Friedrichs v. California's Teachers Association, public union dues, which Stacey's going to go a little bit in on. Whole Women's Health v. Cole, which is an abortion issue. Zubik v. Burwell, which is Obamacare. So as you can see, the calendar in a divided 4-4 court is just going to touch on some of the most important issues the courts adjudicated in about a generation.
Well, it has already bounced one of those back, the California teachers issue. And basically what that was, it was a teacher in California saying, I'm not a member of the union. There was a previous Supreme Court decision that said I'm not allowed to charge me dues if I'm not a member, but they charge me fees instead. And those fees still go to do things like support candidates that I may not support, and collective bargaining. And, you know, the odd part I find about this is the huge differences between
huge
public union laws and private union laws. Because if you look at Wisconsin and Georgia and other right-to-work states, okay, employees who choose not to join a union at their workplace are charged nothing. They pay no dues. They pay no fees to the larger organization. But they're still subject to all of the terms and conditions of employment that is under the union contract. For some reason, public unions are allowed to recover costs.
But it's on a national level something that was similar to what was done in Wisconsin, correct?
For public unions in the 20 or so states that have these kind of rules that allow public unions like teachers unions and government unions to, which to me are just government unions, seriously, who recover these fees, yes, they're going to be allowed to continue to do it until this actually does get heard and re-decided by the Supreme Court. I don't think the issue's dead, but for right now, the Ninth Circuit in California, their ruling will stand.
One of the things I wanted to bring up here is that I found this very interesting because this particular case, the California labor case, was brought by the Center for Individual Rights.
What's the Center for Individual Rights doing, Stacey?
They're a libertarian group that pursued. Now, this I find very interesting because we always go back to the left basically gets legislation codified through Supreme Court edict because they can't sell what they want to do legislatively to the Congress. And you find that the left for decades and decades and decades, it's very similar to the point that Stacey and I make, how our people don't know how to politic. The left has continually judge shopped, venue shopped, and strategically used lawsuits in the courts to get the outcome they wanted. It looks like in this particular case, the right finally caught up with it, but it may have backfired. So this libertarian.
Oh, I think libertarian organizations are much better.
So this
much better at using the courts than traditional Republicans.
Group, Center for Individual Rights, responding to signals from the Supreme Court's more conservative justices, pursued what experts see as an unusual litigation strategy. The group asked the lower courts to rule against its clients. 10 teachers in a Christian education group so that they could file an appeal in the Supreme Court as soon as possible. The reason they did that goes back to the transcripts of Justice Scalia's questions when he first heard oral arguments in that case. And basically, if you looked at his questions in oral argument along with the other four nominally conservative justices, it looked like this was going to be a huge, huge victory for the right. It will be remanded at 4-4. Back down to the lower court, though. And then this goes back to whether the Republicans should confirm Merrick Garland. And I think if you take a look at it, I honestly think the way to go about it was to have all the hearings you want and not nominate. If they want to stand and not have hearings for him, that's fine. But I think that as moderate as he's being sold, I think that Merrick Garland really would take the right generation or two back in the court. Real quick before we hop out to break for the last segment.
The other big one is Obama's executive order.
Right
now, that is subject to injunction by two lower courts in a lawsuit waged by the state of Texas. If that one goes 4-4, that would be awesome.
Right. The best thing that could happen to the right if that went 4-4. So Monday, April 18th, you're going to have U.S. v. Texas on the calendar of the Supreme Court. Monday, the 25th, Kreitzang v. John Wiley and Sons. U.V. Bryant. So you're going to have immigration. You're going to have health care coming up and all sorts of individual rights. And we'll see. I honestly don't think we're going to have a fifth member on that Supreme Court until after the election. And hey, it's a dice roll because if that Empress of Chappaqua, Bernie, has their way, God knows, baby. It's going to be the Queen of Hearts up there judging us. All right, kids, coming back after the next three-minute break, paying some bills. JD and Stacey going to take you out of Sunday into the noon hour with some nonsense of the world and so much more. Go top off your drink, tighten up your stink. Go get yourself whatever helps make you think. JD and Stacey, Game On, part of that Conservative Commandos radio network here on K98 Talk.
Everybody, this is Jason, host of According to Me. I'd like to invite you to check out my show. It's a two-hour show that lasts 60 minutes in...
Listen, I hate to interrupt, but one thing I can do is read off a script. Just say, let me be clear a lot. It works.
President Obama, I can handle this. It's a radio promo. I'm not green. I've done this before.
Did someone say green?
Now, Al Gore is here. Listen, I'm just trying to record a radio promo. Do you mind?
Now, do you say good things about me on the show?
No, not at all. But if it makes you feel any better, I rip on Republicans just as much.
The AM radio frequencies give off very high levels of radiation.
Look, my show is on the internet, which you invented. Can I just do my promo?
I got a pen. I can veto that, you know.
I know you got a pen. It's not a law. It's a radio promo. Listen, just listen to my show. Barack Obama and Al Gore hate it, so you're going
to
love it.
Here's an executive order. Don't listen to a show. He doesn't like me. He's racist.
And he doesn't recycle either.
That's it. I'm done. It's According to Me, Wednesdays, 10 p.m. Eastern, right here on K98 Talk.
Wondering why you're up early with us on a Sunday morning making a cocktail? News lately got you drinking? Hungover from the mainstream media by Sunday? We are, and we got you covered.
We sure do. We got your hangover cure for those weekly news blues. So sit back, top off your mimosa, and add some Baileys to that coffee.
Take a match to your copy of the New York Times. Light, funny, and oh yeah, news with booze.
And a lot of laughter.
Welcome to Bloody Marys and Broadsheets. If it's Sunday, it's Bloody Marys and Broadsheets.
We're your cure from your weekly news hangover.
We will never fully understand what we've asked of our military service members or their families, asking them to put themselves in harm's way, to endure it all. But we do understand that it's our turn, our duty, to keep them secure for the rest of their lives. Wounded Warrior Project long-term support programs help our most severely ill or injured veterans live independently, at no cost, for life, so that they might stand at ease. Join us at findwwp.org.
K98 Talk is expanding its lineup for 2015. This means we are expanding our advertising base. Whether you're a startup trying to push through to the next level, or an established business trying to supplement your advertising budget, web-based advertising is a solid investment. Thanks to Talk's newest partnership with TuneIn Radio and instant access to our sister station, K98 FM, we give you worldwide access at a reasonable cost. Interested parties should email us at sales@k98fm.com.
Welcome back. JD and Stacey here. Game On, part of that Conservative Commandos radio network on K98 Talk. Everybody right now, get over to K98talk.org. Say hello to Stacey. Say hello to listening audience. Join the conversation. Remember, guys, after the show at the noon o'clock hour, get over to Spreaker.com. Hash Brown, JD and Stacey, JDANDSTACEY for a catalog of everything we've been doing here with the boss. Stick around for the boss's show during the week, Monday through Friday, 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. You got that Ricky Tiki Tavi Rick Robinson with that America Off the Rails. And I want to apologize for everybody in the the chat room, I don't know what's going on. I keep getting kicked out, and during the last commercial break, I kept trying to get back in. I just can't, so I don't know if everybody else is having the same
here.
Issue. Yeah, everybody's out?
I can't get back in.
Hey, Rick, if you decide to wake up before noon today, why don't you take a look at the chat room? Oh, no, I'm up early all the time. Yeah, right, because the first time anybody ever hears from you on a Sunday is 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
Right, bro.
Why? Well, you can't say it's not true. We know you're all listening. We just can't see those of you in the chat room. Being that, was this the first time you had seen this thing about Cankles playing dominoes at the senior center?
It actually was, but the mental picture and connection that went on there after I've called the Democratic debates to old white people fighting over the last chocolate pudding in the cafeteria of the old folks' home, it actually made me laugh out loud.
Listen, I've said it before. If I wanted to watch two crazy old white people scream at each other about nonsense while they quietly sleep into senility, I would just hang out with my parents.
That's mean. So, I like your parents.
So basically, we all know that that's
I just became their favorite child on this show.
You were always their favorite child.
On this show.
No, in general. So Cankles goes to scare all the old people out of... I mean, this is great. The fact that her and Bernie Sanders side to side look like two people that are holding a jello riot in the old folks' prison.
There will be... Everybody will get one green jello.
I don't think we should get one green jello. So Hillary Clinton gets really excited playing dominoes at senior home. As soon as I heard this, I was thinking about all the 90s like gang movies, like Boys in the Hood and all that. Could you see us sitting there with some big like gang leader of the Bloods? Domino!
Oh, God.
I think Hillary Clinton just beat
me. This was
me.
Just...
Hold on.
This was just flashback to earlier. I don't know if you remember around the Iowa caucus. They would show the folks that were, you know, all revved up and volunteering for Hillary, and it always looked like the community room of some kind of supportive living center.
Oma, where's my soup? Who are the people in the room? They're talking to me. Oma.
So basically, letting Hillary play dominoes at an old age home is like letting one of the inmates run the asylum. Hillary Clinton was enlivened by a round of dominoes, a game beloved by the elderly. Let me tell you why she's playing dominoes. It has nothing.
She's old?
No, it has nothing to do with old people. This is a photo op for the Latino vote like you have never seen in your life. Why would you say it's for the Latino vote, JD? Because JD lives in New York, you hoopals. And you cannot go north of 96th Street on the east side without passing streets and streets and streets from everybody between the ages of 18 to 80, blind, crippled, and crazy, outside with a game of dominoes and a 40-ounce going, domino! Wait a minute, Hillary Clinton just beat me in dominoes? We can't have that. Looks like we're voting for Bernie. Here's the best part of this article. This is in the Free Beacon. Her excitement is proof that despite speculation of her being a robot, she is, as she once claimed, a real person. Let me tell you something. When you have to stop telling people that you're not, when you have to tell people... She's like, Pinocchio, I'm a real live girl.
If you didn't see that last creepy video of her speaking directly into the camera, who is it? There's a guy on Twitter that says that's reboot 2.0. You know, I mean, she looks so robotic when she's giving prepared statements, but if you watch the video of her winning at Domino's, it's actually kind of frightening.
Well, since we're speaking about old, creepy, washed-up socialists, let's go into fight for 15 protesters, invade fast food restaurant, invite workers to go,
you were all invited to go on strike.
Now, how did that turn out?
Doesn't look like it turned out very well, to be honest. So these fight for 15 protesters, which to me, looking at the video, all look to be under the age of 25, wearing really nice clothes and probably going to college on their parents' dime, walked into a Taco Bell to try to pull a woman who was working there from behind the counter to come on a day of protest with them and go on strike. Here's a clue. Kids, listen. If you're not in a union, you have no right to go on strike. You lose your job. It's called walking off the job.
Here's the best part of it. Because, you know, we live in such an interwebs world, and everybody's working around with the next big selfie and video. I'm going to go viral. I'm going to be famous. Hey, let's go. We're going to have these people on strike, and we're going to get $15 an hour. Except that when you leave something going viral to the fates, every once in a while, the fates might smack you in the face with their schmeckle. So they go to grab this woman at Taco Bell, and they're like, oh, Uncle Bernie says you must make $15 an hour. Come speak to us. She goes, y'all are hindering my work. You may leave the building. The apparent leader of the protest still finished his speech and invited her to go on strike and join the protest, but she didn't seem interested in the least. She basically told them, get your nachos supremo with extra crunchio and go screw. Have you ever been to the Whiskey Bent in Athens, Georgia?
No, I have only been to Athens, Georgia to hear our good friend Charles C.W. Cook speak at UGA. I did not go to that particular establishment, and after reading this article, I probably never will.
So Athens is world famous throughout history for three things. I guess the Greeks invented civilization, anal sex, and fart spray.
You're going out, you're on the week, you know, it's the weekend, late Saturday night, or I guess this would have been late Friday night, actually. Some guy just ruins everybody's good Friday night out by bringing a can of liquid ass, excuse me, yes, that's what it was called, to the bar and spraying it all over the place, apparently. The product did perform as advertised and made everything smell like this young man had eaten far too many beans.
A man was arrested, and this is from onlineathens.com. A man was arrested over the weekend for allegedly using – this is one of the most well-written – a man was arrested over the weekend for allegedly using bottled flatulence. What's flatulence, Stacey? It's farts. To stink up a bar in downtown Athens, that's in Georgia. According to an Athens Clark County police report released Wednesday afternoon, upon arriving at the bar on East Clayton Avenue at about 1:40 a.m. Saturday, police saw several patients of Do Not Go to the Whiskey Bent on East Clayton Avenue in Athens, Georgia. So several patrons of the Whiskey Bent began to leave quickly while making comments about how bad it stunk inside the bar. Bar patrons pointed out 20-year-old, who shouldn't have been in the bar, Blake Leland Zango as the culprit, and one woman accused Zango of spraying her face. JD's Barstool Pickup Tips. If you want the nice lady you're speaking to blow on your schmeckle, do not spray her in the face with fart spray. When police found Zango in the bar's patio area, he claimed not to know what was going on and said he didn't spray anything. Zango was described in the police report as being very inebriated and was slurring his words. When police searched the Oconee County resident, they found in his pants pocket a spray bottle of liquid ass, which appears to have worked as advertised. Okay.
Okay, terrific.
Moral of this story, the Whiskey Bent on East Clayton Avenue in Athens, Georgia, is about to undergo either a name and or ownership change. Okay, since we can't get away from them and we only have 2 minutes, wait, blah, blah, blah. I swear, sometimes I feel like we were put on the earth to tell the people in radio that the robots are taking over the world.
Well, this just cracks me up because artificial quote-unquote intelligence is so intelligent that they put an AI bot on Twitter who immediately couldn't think through anything remotely socially appropriate. So if they're going to take over, yeah, we are pretty much over because they don't think through things.
You really have to take a look at this. If you haven't heard of that, check out Microsoft's Twitter bot that came out and was basically
hey,
like,
where are the white women at?
Which was basically the most wild thing it said. It became a king of racism. This goes through that AI could destroy humanity within decades. I think Donald Trump's already doing that. That a Professor Hawking has said past that the development of full artificial intelligence could spell the end of the human race. You know, we're sitting here worried about these Muppets and puppets running for president. We got to worry about the robots, baby. They're going to make your breakfast, and one day they're going to lock you in the basement, steal your car and your baby, and they're making love to your baby better than your gravy. However, the fastest hour in conservative radio is just wrapping up. We want to thank everybody for joining us on this Sunday morning for Game On, part of that conservative Commandos Radio Network here in that K98 Talk. It is the part on Sunday right before the noon o'clock hour where I look at my beautiful and brilliant co-host and I say, baby girl, baby girl, baby girl, you got those keys?
Oh, I got those keys. Get up on out of here.
Let's get out of here. Tell the nice people where they can find you.
You can find me on Twitter at ScottsFire, S-C-O-T-S-F-Y-R-E, and on Facebook at Stacey Lennox. And be sure to like our new show page, JD and Stacey.
Get over to the Facebook JD and Stacey show page and like that, baby. Keep your eye out. Website coming soon. Myself, Stacey, sold out all my basic bad habits. That's going to kill me. I got a bulletproof vest. You know where to find me. Barstools, alleyways. Somebody's going to take a shot at me if I live through it. I'll see you Tuesday.
I'm looking for you, you Occupy freaks, with your glitter bombs. Bring it on. Bring on the glitter. Everything has changed. Everything has changed in the last few years. Conservatives used to take it, and we're not taking it anymore.
If you want to work until you keel over, have less of everything in retirement, or give back more of your hard-earned money to the stock market again, then just ignore me. But if you'd like to protect the money you save, receive a steady, predictable retirement income, and enjoy financial security for as long as you live, then listen to this. You can download a free report that reveals the wealth-building secrets Wall Street and the banks don't want you to know. You'll learn how you can get guaranteed growth, safety, and real prosperity without risking your money in the Wall Street casino, and how to get the money you need when you need it, simply by asking for it. This is the best way to have a 100% secure retirement and know your money will last as long as you do. To learn more about this method and to get your free report, go to 29security.com. That's the number 29security.com. 29security.com. Go to 29security.com. If you want to work until you keel over, have less of everything in retirement, or give back more of your hard-earned money to the stock market again, then just ignore me. But if you'd like to protect the money you save, receive a steady, predictable retirement income, and enjoy financial security for as long as you live, then listen to this. You can download a free report that reveals the wealth-building secrets Wall Street and the banks don't want you to know. You'll learn how you can get guaranteed growth, safety, and real prosperity without risking your money in the Wall Street casino, and how to get the money you need when you need it, simply by asking for it. This is the best way to have a 100% secure retirement and know your money will last as long as you do. To learn more about this method and to get your free report, go to 29security.com. That's the number 29security.com. 29security.com. Go to 29security.com.
That's not how it works. That's not how any of this works.